We know that according to the scriptures, the Bible speaks of the mark of the beast, a bank system set up where there will be no money in the system, and which soon everything will be credit, and they have the RFID chip out there, and they already have it set up where some people are getting it right now.
Can I ask?
Let me say what I'm saying, though. When this system come out called the mark of the beast, to be injected with a monetary chip in their hand, because you don't believe in the New Testament, will you be chipped?
Sorry?
Will you open yourself to be chipped by an RFID chip?
Yeah.
To spend money?
Yeah?
Yeah?
I mean, what do you want me to answer? Yes, no?
No.
What do you want me to answer?
Would you do that? Would you get chipped to spend your money?
Yep, because they want to get the Rothschilds and
the elites.
And they want to get rid of the money system. Now everything is credit cards, man. You go into Macy's and pay something with cash, they're going to look at you funny.
They're making commercials like that.
They're making commercials about that,
where they scoff at cash.
So what they want people, they want to get rid of the paper dollar system, and they want to put the debit cards. Then from the debit cards, eventually, what they're going to do is they're going to have you take this chip.
That's right.
And the masses, the people, don't know what it's all about.
Right.
And the only place that it's mentioned is in the Bible. It's not mentioned in the Quran. It's not mentioned in the Kibra Negas, the Metaneta, the Epic of Gilgamesh. It's not mentioned. The only book that is mentioned is in the scriptures. That
a microscopic tag be implanted in a person's body to track his every movement. There's actual discussion about that. You will rule on that, mark my words, before your tenure is over. Can brain scans be used to determine whether a person is inclined toward criminality or violent behavior?
Avante's law, named after your late son. The legislation will ensure that DOJ has the funding it needs to administer a brand new grant program for children with autism, modeled after its current program for people with Alzheimer's. The program will allow funding to be used for voluntary GPS tracking devices for children with autism, and it will ensure that operators know how to work these devices. The devices are sometimes a form of
both small and great.
Shalom. And welcome to another installment of Apostles of GMS, giving all praise to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, of course. And I'm going to say that as much as my lips allow me to say it. All praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. All praises to Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. I don't give a damn what Nate the Snake says. Okay, he can say Christ, call on Christ all he wants. When that destruction come, I want to hear him call on Christ. See if a white man come and save him. White man jump off the cross, come and save his ass. It ain't going to happen. Anyway, today's topic is entitled, and this is from a scriptural a verse in the scriptures, all right? But there was no breath in them. And that's from Ezekiel 37, verse 8. But I would like the reader to start from the top. And we're going to read that.
Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 1. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord power, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord.
See, this is the reason why we were sent. This is the reason why we were born on this earth. To live your certain life as an adolescent, a toddler, an adolescent, you know, you went to elementary school, you went to high school, some of you dropped out of high school, then your simple ass thought you were doing the wrong thing and you did it like 2 years of college, you know, well, most of y'all did, you know, some of y'all dropped out of high school, you know, you got your little factory jobs, drove cabs, become security guards, worked in supermarkets, all kind of shit, all right? Not realizing that all that stuff that you did led up to what we're doing right now is teaching the word of the Most High. Because that demon Nate said that a guy claims that he's been in this thing for 30 years, but what has he shown for himself? What have I shown myself is what I've been doing for the last 30 years, from year one to year number 30, is teaching his word. I never set up no goddamn fashion shows, all right? You know, I didn't open up a bunch of schools, okay? I didn't take trips all over the place. Get a charter bus, you know? I didn't get a 501c3, although you said that, well, even One West, the elders. Well, wait a minute. If the elders are doing everything right and you're using them as a reference, why in the fuck did you leave them, man? If they were doing everything right and you said, well, even the elders of One West, why did you leave them, man? Nigga? Huh? What do I have to show for myself? I've been doing the work of the Most High, unlike you, man. I every winter for the past 30 years, I've been 30 years, man. I can act 30 years. 30 winters. I've been out. I haven't missed one winter. Can you say that? You don't come out at all, period, man. And we're going to ride your ass, man. See, what you did was you gathered a bunch of Israelites around and you turned them into zombies, man. Okay? You turned them into dry bones. They were dry bones and you made them even drier, man. I mean, you made them look good. You made them say that they're Israelites. But when it came to call on the Lord, who did they call on? Christ! Sweet Jesus, man.
They can't even break down scriptures correctly. Like Galatians.
Well, they never did a response to that.
Yep, Galatians, you know? Third chapter.
They never did a response to that, man. You know? And then you Levites, man. No, I'm going to say you Haitians. You Haitians got a fucking... You got a lot of nerve following a damn... Some guy... I don't know if he's a Gadite or a Judite. You niggas are out of your fucking mind, man. And that's why the Most High got your ass in that earthquake, man. And most of you guys in the IUIC should have been down there when the earthquake hit and should have got pancaked by a supermarket or a goddamn building, man. And we ain't forgot about you, Johanna. We ain't forgot about you, man. Now, we're going to talk about Tazariah, right? Now, he got an ongoing thing with Sarnetta. Now, Sarnetta sent up a Nigerian boy, and he said he want to go to the picnic, right? And he said, yeah, you can go to the picnic. But then he said, I'm from Nigeria. So what does Captain Tazariah, Captain Terrific, say? Nah, you can't come because you're a Hamite. See, that's going to show you that there's nothing spiritual about you, man. See, Johanna saw you and saw you was about things. You know, you were about doing something. And he gave him ranks. He put you up. He led you up that ladder, man. But guess what? You on that high pedestal, and you're still a little baby, man. You're not spiritual, man. You're not spiritual. Because if you were spiritual, you'd have been with GMS. If you was one of the elect, you would have been with GMS. And then you're gonna take that boy that said he was from Nigeria, and he can't. First of all, if you know history, you know that Israel came from West Africa. So a lot of them Israelites stayed in West Africa, man. That shows you that you guys are not on no level, man. That's why you got some guys that say Cornelius is an Edomite. You got others guys that say the mark of the beast is an embargo or Christianity or whatever the hell you wanted to say it is. Oh, now it's fornication, okay? That's why I played that montage, man. Because even the GOCC, as bugged out as that organization is, they even know that the mark of the beast is a chip. And they're breaking it down right. But they're bugged out. Okay? Go ahead. Let's read that from the top again.
This is back in Ezekiel 37:1. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones. And caused me to...
What's that valley?
America. That valley is America.
How do we know America is that valley?
The word valley means low land. And the reason why America is known as a low land is because they're low in morals, you know, and pretty much, I mean, even as we speak now, they just passed legislation where same-sex marriage is going to be accepted nationwide, all 50 states, you know. So that's, you can't get no lower than that. You know, the role reversal of the man and the woman, you know, you got he-she's out there. You don't even know if they're a man or a woman, you know.
And then, see, what makes this whole thing happen is the Supreme Court. Not the executive, not the legislature, not the Senate, but the Supreme Court. Whatever the nine members of the Supreme Court says, that's the word of God. They said they went up to the Supreme Court. It was a certiorari to the Supreme Court. It's not an appeal for you niggas that think you know law. It's called... In lower courts, you do appellate briefs. You do appeals to other higher courts. But if you go to the Supreme Court, it's called a certiorari, all right, to the Supreme Court. So what happened was that went before the Supreme Court, the nine members of the Supreme Court, and their conclusion was, because they're supposed to interpret law. How you going to have, a 5-4, a 6-3? That's not interpreting nothing, man. What's the interpretation of this? It ain't, well, he won because five guys said yes, and the other four said no. That's not interpretation, man. That's a vote. That's the very definition of democracy, man. If you went to the Supreme Court and said that the moon should be called the sun, and they rule, yes, the moon should be called the sun, then it becomes the sun. How stupid is that? That's why the scriptures refer to this place as Babylon the Great. The word Babel means confusion. Valley of Death. But anyway, they said that it's all right for men to marry men and women to marry women. Now, I went to the highest court of the land, and basically, you just sign your death certificate. I'm talking about Babylon. You just sign your death certificate. This is the beginning of the end for you fucking devils, man. Okay? This is the beginning of the end. And then, what they did was, they had Barack Obama. He was 100% with it, man. And then they made the White House look like the color of the rainbow, which is the official colors of the, the LGBT. All right? So that wasn't the White House. That was the LGBT White House. Now, what's going on in the White House? And what's going on with my man, the great gospel singer, Barack Obama? When is he going to be real? Huh? When is he going to be real? He's always with somebody being married, a man marrying another man. When is he going to get real? Huh? Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. He trying to sing that damn, and them Jakes in the background, they were Jakes. They were kind of looking at him like, what's wrong with this nigga? But they were going along with him. You'll see it. You'll see it, you know? But anyway, everything's coming into play like it's supposed to come into play, man. And see, basically, what we're doing is we see the prophecies. Watch, the scriptures say watch as well as pray. We're doing that. We're praying on it. And we're prophesying on it, and we're linking it up with the scriptures. This place is done, man. Jade Helm 15 is what? Another couple of weeks away. And that's from what? July?
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Freedom Fighter 2127.
July 15th to September 15th. And a lot of you niggas don't even know about it, man.
Consciously enlightened.
A lot of you are following this black consciousness bullshit, which I call black Babylonianism.
In the middle of America.
And all you niggas that's into that black Babylonian bullshit, the Most High is going to destroy you.
It is in.
Missouri.
If you're not with
Jade Helm 15,
knowing that you're an Israelite and teaching the way that GMS teaches,
I got inside information.
And like Ariel said, you got to teach it the way I say it. Well, you got to teach it the way GMS says teach it, because the Most High set us up to be the teachers, the truth teachers, man. Most High didn't set up Nate. Most High didn't set up General Johanna. The Most High didn't set up the GOCC. The Most High didn't set up Nasi, Zion Lex. The Most High didn't set up the Divine Prospect. The Most High set up the Great Millstone. Whatever we go in, when we go in the scriptures, and whatever we teach in the scriptures, that's the word of the Most High, because it's coming from the Most High. The Most High opened our eyes to teach this word the right way. Go ahead, read that, Ak.
This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 19, verse 14. The Lord hath mingled a perverse spirit in the midst thereof, and they have caused Egypt to err in every work thereof, as a drunken man staggereth in his vomit. So the Lord is the one that mingled this perverse spirit here. You know, and everything is being demoralized. You know, women acting like men acting like women. You know, getting sex changes. You know, role reversals in the house. You know, I mean, all kind of madness that's going on. And that's the reason why this country is going down the drain. It's circling the drain. It's going to hell, so to speak. You know, destruction. Because this place is corrupt. You know, that's why the Lord calls it the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth. Back in Ezekiel 37 and 2, it says, and caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And that represents you Israelites out there, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native American Indians. You're those dry bones in the valley. And the reason why you're dry is because you don't have your nationality. You don't know that you're Israelites. And those of you that know that you're Israelites, you're still in the valley, right? Because you have no breath in you, because you deny the name of the Lord, or you deny, you know, certain prophecies or certain breakdowns of the scriptures, you know, certain key teachings in the scriptures, you know, that make you not have that breath or that oil in you. All right, it says verse 3, and he said unto me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord, power, thou knowest. Again said he unto me, prophesy upon these bones, and say unto them, O ye dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. And that's what we're doing out there. We're prophesying in the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai to the dry bones. You know, you Israelites out there. It says, thus saith the Lord, power unto these bones. Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. You know, and the breath represents these scriptures. Like the scriptures spoke about Adam, you know, and they said the Lord breathed into his nostril and man became a living soul. That's when the Lord breathed into Adam, the understanding, you know, because that understanding was what gave him clarity on making, you know, whatever decision he had to make based off of, like back then, it was oral. You know, he had the laws, statutes, and commandments, but they were oral. You know, so he gave man an understanding above all every creature on the earth. He separated man from creatures. Okay, so that breath was that understanding. So the Lord said, thus saith the Lord, power unto these bones. Behold, I will cause breath to enter into you, and you shall live. And how did that happen? By the prophets going out there and teaching, and the those of Israel out there that are in the calling stage, you know, hearing the word and waking up. And, you know, and taking that breath. It says, so I prophesied, I'm sorry, and I will lay sinews upon you, and will bring up flesh upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord. That's your nationality, you know, coming back to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh, that you're an Israelite, you know, knowing about the Lord, what the Lord is about, you know, the laws, the statutes, commandments, the history, you know, the judgments, the prophecies of the scriptures, the mysteries of the Gentile issue and other issues in the scriptures. It says, so verse 7, so I prophesied as I was commanded, and as I prophesied, there was a noise, and behold, a shaking, and the bones came together, bone to his bone. You know, and that's Israelites coming back together, bone to his bone. And when I beheld, lo, the sinews and the flesh came up upon them, and the skin covered them above. So they woke up. But it says, but there was no breath in them. Why was there no breath in them? Because there were certain parts of that spiritual meat, so to speak, or spiritual breath that they didn't take in. You know, they were missing the oil. You got something, brother?
Yes, this is Wisdom of Solomon 7 and 24. For wisdom is more moving than any motion. She passeth and goeth through all things by reason of her pureness. For she is the breath of the power of the Most High, and a pure influence flowing from the glory of the Almighty.
Right, that's the breath. Go ahead.
Therefore can no defiled thing fall into her.
That's why these particular individuals cannot have that breath, because the scriptures say that they could know. Read that part again.
For she is the breath of the power of the Most High, and a pure influence flowing from the glory of the Almighty. Therefore can no defiled thing fall into her.
Right, therefore can no defiled thing fall into her. Now there's another scripture in the Apocrypha, where I believe it's in the same book of Wisdom of Solomon, where it speaks about that wisdom will not enter into malicious souls. You know, so some of you guys out there, the Lord is not allowing you to get the full breath, the full understanding. You got it?
Yeah. Something? This is Wisdom of Solomon 1 and 4. For unto a malicious soul, wisdom shall not enter.
That's right. You know, unto a malicious soul, wisdom will not enter. That's why you got these guys that call themselves leaders, and instead of teaching the word, teaching the truth, they're taking bribes, you know, to change the doctrine. They're taking bribes to that's one of the main things that they do away with is the name of the Lord. You know, they're quick to do away with the name of the Lord. Now this devil Nate, you know, he did a video, and in the video he said, if you have a 501c3, they say you can't say the name of the Lord. He said the name of the Lord is Yahweh. And then he said, what's the name of the Lord? And he told the congregation to repeat it. And they said, Yahweh. See? So if I couldn't teach the name of the Lord, why did I just teach it? Well, first of all, you said the name of the Most High. And it's not, you can't go directly to the Most High. You got to go through his son, Yahweh Shai, which is the mediator.
Later in that video, he said that he went into Joshua, that's the, in the Hebrew, Yehoshua is the name he's, the way you say Yahweh Shai's name. And then he said that he said Yehoshua is the name, the way you say Jesus' name. And he said the eye sound, that's what they put in there in One West. So some of you guys are questioning. See, he calls you guys that follow him, that are kind of watching our videos and questioning what we're saying. He calls you guys window shoppers. Well, you need to stop window shopping and go and buy, man. You know, when you window shop and see what sneakers you like, you better go in there and buy them, man. You better make that purchase, man, because the way, Nate's way is not the right way, man. Nate is leading you into hell, okay? He's leading you into hell, okay? Which is destruction, death. Hey, this is Job 17 and 1. It says, my breath is corrupt. My days are extinct. The graves are ready for me. Hey, so death is coming, man. See, Nate's been warned. Nate said back at the, the house of David, that I was at the highest rank and I should have just put my foot down and did. Well, nigga, I've been saying that to you for the longest. Why you think we get on your ass pretty much every week? Because your ass ain't right, man. But then you got your fucking zombies, your stupid zombies, all right? Whatever the hell you say, they go with, man. Whatever the hell you say, they go with. If you was to teach that Cornelius was an Edomite, they would have went with that. And then if we said, look, Cornelius is an Israelite, they would have bucked up against us. And this demon, Baron Samedi, he would have been making videos saying that Cornelius is an Edomite. See, you guys are zombies, man. I know you don't like hearing that, but it's true. You guys are zombies, man. You don't have your own mind. The spirit of the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahweh, is not
Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is not dealing with you. You know what spirit is dealing with you? The spirit of Christ. That's why every time Nate says something, he'll say Christ. Because he was paid off. He was set up. Okay? And then to confuse you, man. Because I got another video I'm going to bring up where I'm going to break this thing down about Nate pushing this, the mark of the beast thing, talking about it's an embargo. You know, it's talking about nations. Hey, man, the game plan is getting ready to stop, man. The Most High set up the men of the Most, his men, to get your act together. But if you ain't going to get your act together, the Most High going to bring his men back, which are us. And then he's going to bring death. And death is an actual spirit, man. And when, see, death, he's going to have his last hurrah. So when the Most High allows death to do his thing, he's going to do his finest work, man. He's going to kill you niggas left and right. He's going to get busy. He ain't going to take no coffee breaks. You know, he ain't going to pity you. When death does his thing, because he already knows. He's sitting there waiting for the Most High to go ahead, death, do your thing. This is your last hurrah. And he's going to do his finest work. And he's going to let you niggas have it, man. He's going to let you Latin tribes have it. He's going to let all you tribes have it. He's going to fuck you up. He's going to make you believe. He's going to do his thing, man. The Most High is going to tell him, look, death, this is the last time. This is the last time. This is the last hurrah. After this, I'm going to give you X amount of time. I'm going to give you from this date to that date. Let's see what you can do. Because once you do this, you ain't going to do it no more. I'm going to put you somewhere. We ain't going to need you no more, man. So when the Most High goes to death and tell him, look, do your thing, you know what? Hold the mic to my mouth, man. Death is going to be like this. He's going to be licking his chops, man. And he's going to go full speed on you niggas, man. He's going to get all you niggas in that black Babylonianism, what you call a black consciousness. Watch what he's going to do to Polite. Watch what he's going to do to Sarnetta. Watch what he's going to do to all you niggas that believe in Kemet, man. All you niggas in Islam, Farrakhan, all the fruits of Islam, all right? The Moors. You Jehovah Witnesses, you Seventh-day Adventists, you Baptists, you Methodists, you Roman Catholics, you Episcopals. I'm talking about that church down there. That was a little inkling of what death is going to do, man. And here you talking about you forgive death? He going to do his thing. Go ahead, Ak.
This is the book of 2 Samuel 24 and 14. And David said unto Gad, I am in a great strait. Let us fall now into the hand of the Lord, for his mercies are great, and let me not fall into the hand of man. So the Lord sent a pestilence upon Israel from the morning even to the time appointed, and there died of the people from Dan even to Beersheba 7,000 men. And when the angel stretched out his hand upon Jerusalem to destroy it, the Lord repented him of the evil and said to the angel that destroyed the people, it is enough, stay now thine hand. And the angel of the Lord was by the threshing place of Arauna and the Jebusite.
And that, I got news for you, that wasn't even death, that was just an angel. See, angels can be appointed to kill people, but that wasn't death. Okay, when death does his thing, you're gonna know about it, man. You're going to know that there is an actual spirit. There was an actual spirit that put you to sleep. The reason why them guys in the black Babylonianism are the way they are, because there's an actual spirit that put them to sleep, man. The reason why you got guys out there calling themselves Moors, and that they descended from the Moabites and the Canaanites, that's that same spirit. That spirit is creative, man. He's going to take a certain amount of you Israelites. He's going to make you think that you're Moors. He going to take another group and make you think that Islamic, you know? He going to take another group of y'all and make y'all think that y'all Baptist. And you know what the end result of that is? Death. Death is going to come in, man. Death is going to be the showstopper. Death is coming, man. And like I said, this is going to be his finest. Oh, well, even Leland Gump, he said, what did he say? He said, this wasn't my finest work. How'd he say it? Work. What? What?
Oh, this is not my best work?
He said, this is not my best work. That was death.
Yeah.
He went in there. He tore that town up, man. And he drove out in that damn, whatever, limousine or whatever, that black, he spit out of there, car. Man. And he said, this is not my finest work.
Yep.
Well, death is going to get his last hurrah. And he's going to make sure that's going to be his finest work. Okay?
This is the book of Ecclesiastes 41 and 4. And why art thou, 41 and 3. Fear not the sentence of death. Remember them that have been before thee and that come after. For this is the sentence of the Lord over all flesh. And why art thou against the pleasure of the Most High? There is no inquisition in the grave, whether thou have lived 10 or 100 or 1,000 years. This is the book of Proverbs 13:13. It said, whoso despiseth the word shall be destroyed, but he that feareth the commandment shall be rewarded. So you guys in the IUIC out there, you despise the word of the Lord because you know what Nate is saying is wrong. You're just repeating what he's saying. You know that what he's saying is wrong, and you're allowing it. And the reason why he's doing this damage control is because you got guys within his congregation, as the apostle Elder Tar said, that are questioning the things that he's doing. And some guys are leaving, and some guys are meditating and thinking about leaving, you know, because they're seeing the BS. You know, the Lord is slowly but surely pulling that zombie-like state off of them, and they're starting to see Nate for what he really is, a real demon.
Yeah, because he did that video. He started off with these women. Don't worry, I'm gonna get with y'all women about your husbands. Hold on, what kind of shit is that, man? You mean to tell me these women are so righteous that they're more righteous than their husband? You fucking zombies, man. You window shoppers, you better go ahead and buy that product, man. And stop looking through the window. Stop pairing. Oh, I think I'm going to get them Jordans. You better go ahead and get that money out. And you better go ahead and buy it, man. You better hurry up and cop it, man. Anyway, I got this scripture right here. This is James 8 and 51, right? I'm sorry, John 8 and 51. It said, verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. Like, in other words, if you ain't right, you're going to run into death. You're going to see that nigga, man. And he's a nigga. You know how you go through a dark alleyway and you see some big 7-foot-tall mean nigga? That's how death's going to come, man. And right before you die, you're going to see him, man. In other words, you're going to feel the presence. You're going to know it's death. Let me read that again. It's knocking at your door. It said, verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death. Now, I'm going to tell you something, man. Mark my words. Take my advice. You don't want to see death. You don't want to see that guy. Okay?
This is St. John chapter 3, verse 36. He that believeth on the Son hath everlasting life. And he that believeth not the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of the Most High abideth on him. And that's you guys in the IUIC and other groups, but we're dealing with you right now. You know, a lot of you guys denying the Son. And this is what the Lord said in Luke 12 and 9. But he that denieth me before men shall be denied before the angels of the Most High. So when the time comes for the deliverance to come, you're not going to be delivered. Because you're denying the Son. By you not teaching the Lord's name, you're denying the Son. And Nate is a devil because he knows what he's doing. You know, he's purposely misleading you and confusing you. That's why he keeps throwing out, you know, one time he was just saying, you know, the Most High's name and Yahweh Shai's name. Now he's throwing a Jehoshua and the pronunciation came from over here. And this, because he's confusing you. He's not giving you the true name of the Lord. But he is, and then he's mixing it up with other stuff. So he knows exactly what he's doing. You know, and for you window shoppers, you know that are seeing that, you better get away from that dude. You know, because once the Lord gives that decree for death to come looking for you, you can't get out of it. You know, at least the Lord have mercy upon you.
Yeah, I got a scripture. This is the book of 1 John 5 and 12. It says, he that have the Son have life, mm-hmm. and he that have not the Son of the Most High have not life.
That's right.
So they have death.
That's right.
Hey, wasn't Nate the one that said a few videos back, he said, because a nigga will jump up and say, Yahweh!
Yep.
Right? He said that in one of those videos. Now he's changing. This nigga changes every what? Every year? Every 2 years? He changes his doctrine? And then the scriptures say, meddle not with them that are given to change. He's always changing.
That's right.
How can you believe in a guy like that, that changes every year, every 2 years?
That's right. He's unstable. This is 1 Corinthians 12 and 3. Wherefore I give you to understand, this is how you understand, that no man speaking by the Spirit of the Most High calleth Yahushua cursed. And that no man can say that Yahweh Shai is the Lord but by the Holy Spirit. And that's why you guys are calling on Jesus and Christ and all that, because you don't have the Holy Spirit with you. You know, you don't, it says no man speaking by the Spirit of the Most High calleth Yahweh Shai accursed. And by you not using his name or switching his name up, you're calling him accursed. You had a scripture?
Yeah, this is Jeremiah 15 and 1. Then said the Lord unto me, though Moses and Samuel stood before me, yet my mind could not be toward this people. Cast them out of my sight, and let them go forth. And it shall come to pass, if they say unto thee, whither shall we go forth? Then thou shalt tell them, thus saith the Lord, such as are for death to death, and such as for the sword to the sword, and such as are the famine to the famine, and such as are for the captivity to the captivity. And I'll appoint over them four kinds, saith the Lord, the sword to slay, and the dogs to tear, and the fowls of the heaven, and the beasts of the earth to devour and to destroy.
You can speak on it if you want.
Yeah, basically it's going into the destruction of 2/3 of the nation of Israel that don't want to acknowledge what's being taught, the truth that's being taught. All right, because the Most High, he set up his prophets to show the right way. All right, everybody else is coming in the spirit of deception, all right, to basically lead you astray, all right, from the truth. And the only ones that's going to be led away from the truth is the ones that the Most High has rejected.
That's it. Yeah, that's it, you know, because the bottom line, you know, here it is, you know, we've been out there teaching, you know, and that name has been taught, and every time you get some infiltration going in through these different schools that were set up, you know, the first thing they take out is the name. You know, now they might leave the name of the Most High, Yahweh, but they always take that name Yahweh Shai out, because they don't want you to get to the Most High through that name, because that's a big key. Without that key, you ain't going nowhere. You know, you can go, you could try to bang on the door, you could try to pick the lock, you could try to go under the door, over the door, around the door, but if you ain't got that key, you ain't getting through that door, no matter what you do. You know, because there's a spiritual force holding it back.
Well, he said he's the door. Yahushua said he's the door.
Exactly.
Yeah.
In other words, for you to get to the Most High, Yahweh, you got to come through the mediator, the middleman.
I got it right here.
The advocate. You got to come through him. You just can't come directly to the Most High.
That's right.
You got to come through the middleman. And see, they'll tell you the elite that, you know, gave these guys whatever they wanted, guys like Nate, Yohana, Comfy, and they all did the same thing. Even though Yohana, he might start off with Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, if he teaching a class, he's gonna say Christ, Christ, Christ. Okay, he's gonna keep saying that. So to make the name not important, not significant, that's a middleman. Anytime you pray to the Father, you gotta go through the Son. You gotta say Yahweh Bashem Yahushai, Yahweh. In the name of Yahweh Shai, I grant, I ask this, I beg of this, I ask for this, that, and the other. You can't say Yahweh in the name of Christ. You can't say the Most High in the name of Christ. But like I said, you guys are zombies and you're under that spell. But some of you are beginning to kind of break through that spell and you're window shoppers, man. See, that's a step up. But you got to go past being a window shopper. You got to go in there and buy, man. You got to go in there and buy that product. The product that you're looking, thinking about getting, you better go ahead and buy it. Go ahead, Ak.
This is the book of 1 Timothy 2 and 5. It says, for there's power and one mediator between the Heavenly Father and men, and that men being the Israelite man, the man Yahushai. So you got to.
And it's not Christ.
Yeah, you got to come through the mediator. And by the way, there's a scripture, I think it's in Romans, it says Yahushai is the one intercessor. He is the intercessor for us, between us and the Most High. You need the intercessor.
The advocate, the middleman.
The advocate, the lawyer,
Attorney, the attorney.
The attorney.
That represents you.
Yeah, Yahushai's position is great, man. You can't just bypass Yahushai and go to the Heavenly Father. Yeah.
That's why they allow Comfy to tell his congregation, which is mostly women and dumbass niggas. They tell you, yeah, you can use the word Yahweh, but you got to do away with that word Yahweh Shai.
Yeah. That's right. Oh, I looked up the word mediator.
Yep, you got it.
From the Greek, let me just play it.
Strong's G 3316, Mesites. Mesites.
And it says, one who intervenes between two. Now, the two is us and the Most High. Either in order to make or restore peace. Now, one of Yahushua's title is the Prince of Peace. Why was he called the Prince of Peace? Because he made peace between the nation of Israel and the Most High, Yahweh. Because remember, the Most High, Yahweh, had cast us off as a nation. So there had to be some kind of reconciliation. Peace had to be made between us and the Heavenly Father. The Heavenly Father was that pissed with us. So in steps Yahweh Shai. So how can you just brush him off? That shows you don't know the history too. Either in order to make or restore peace and friendship, or form a compact, or for ratifying a covenant. Also, Yahweh Shai is the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant. That's why when they went to Yahushua's tomb, they had the angels, the two angels, sitting at the foot of the tomb. No, one at the head of the tomb, and the other was at the foot, which represents what? The Ark of the Covenant, because the Ark of the Covenant was designed that way. Yeah. Now, an Ark is something you use to get over on the other side.
The Ark was Yahushua.
Yeah, the Ark is Yahushua. Because
it was a physical, because we really don't need that Ark, you know, even though it's still around.
Mm-hmm.
The ark was a picture of Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
That's why the ark, like you said, you had a cherubim on either side with his wings folded
right
to each other. And the same thing happened when Yahweh Shai was in the tomb, man.
Right.
He was the actual ark.
Yeah.
So you go to him.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And the ark is something you use to get over. Like a welder's ark. The fire arcs, and then it does what it's supposed to do. Yeah, man. So that shows, once again, they don't know the meaning of words, and they don't know the history.
Yeah, and then when you had the Holy of Holies, where the ark was at, the presence of the Lord would come there, you know, to meet with the high priest, you know, to make intercession. The priest would make the intercession with the people. But now Yahweh Shai is the Ark of the Covenant, because that's what the presence of the Lord deals with. He doesn't deal with us directly. He deals with Yahweh Shai.
That's why the veil in the temple ripped.
That's right.
When Yahweh Shai was, when he gave up the spirit, when he said it is finished, yep. Right after that, shortly after that, the veil in the temple just ripped in two.
That's right.
Because he is the Holy of Holies. He's the arbiter. He's the go-between man, between us and the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Oh, back in Revelation, when the elders said, thou art worthy, because thou hast was slain and has redeemed us, to the most high, we're talking about Yahweh Shai. It says a lamb that stood as he had been slain, That was Yahweh Shai. So there's so many references that prove that Yahweh Shai is the one we're supposed to go to get to Yahweh, the Heavenly Father.
That's right. Yeah, I think there's more to that definition.
Reading on, it says a medium of communication. A medium, because Yahweh Shai is the one that communicates to the Heavenly Father for us. All right? Arbitrator. Which, like Apostle Elder Todd said, an arbiter. When you look up the word arbiter, that's the go-between person. Yep. That's the peacemaker, you know?
Attorney.
Yep, attorney. Yep. I looked that word up, arbitrator, and it says, an independent person or body officially appointed to settle a dispute.
The go-between.
Yeah, because Yahweh Shai is the one that's making the intercessions. You know, he's the one that's going up there and praying in our stead, you know? So, you know, if you don't have Yahweh Shai, you have nothing. So you got to go through that name. So by you denying that name, you denying the Lord. You denying the way to the Father. You coming up some other way. You sneaking up in through that window. You know, you coming in like that Judas goat.
Coming in like Brother Man and Martin. You know, that cock diesel nigga. Come right through the window. You got some food. Like a real nigga, man. That's how you coming. Like Brother Man. You'll see it. Yeah, there's a scripture. John 10, I think it is. John. Oh, man. Look at that. John 10. Hey, well, that's the spirit, man. Because Yahweh Shai got to be acknowledged, man.
Yeah, man, because you know what, you guys, Salaki, you guys are nothing but hirelings, man. You know, you just hired just to do a particular job for a certain period of time, and then you stop. You don't continue on. You know, you don't really care about the flock, because if you cared about the flock, you would be out there teaching the flock. You know, constantly nourishing the flock. What did Yahweh Shai tell Peter? If you love me, feed my sheep and feed my lamb.
Yeah, feed them with GMO garbage.
Right.
And all you other groups, that's what you got, GMO knowledge. Hey, like the brother in England, he gave a title. He gave you all a title. Y'all are white man Israelites. Like IUIC, nothing but a white man Israelite group. Hey, you worship Christ. Christ is a so-called white man, man. This is John 10 and 1. It says, verily, verily, which means truly, I say unto you, this is Yahweh Shai speaking, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold. Now, who's the door? Yahweh Shai is the door. He that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way. Yep. That means coming.
To the climbeth up some other way.
Yeah.
Wearing them fancy garments.
Yep, yep.
All color coordinated. You know, when them guys, they color coordinated.
Right, right.
Okay, like cops. Well, cops, yep. Undercover cops.
Yeah.
DTs.
Yeah.
Clean clothes.
Yeah.
They'll tell you in the morning, this is the color for the day. The color's blue.
Oh, yeah.
Navy
yeah.
blue. The color's red.
Yeah.
You know, the color's black and white. You know?
Yeah.
So that's a code, man. And like when we go down there and speak, you look, you see three guys, and they all got the same color jackets on. You know the motherfuckers are cops, man.
Yeah, kind.
You know? So Nate learned that from these devils, man.
Kind.
He got those guys going up, okay, we're going to wear the beige garments. Okay, we're going to wear my favorite color, the purple and gold.
Yeah.
Okay?
And they got to all buy those garments from you.
Yeah, that's so, another way for him to make that money.
Yeah, you and your vampirous wife. All right? They all got to buy that. They can't, let's say a brother will say, well, I got my woman. She can make that garment. Oh, no. You got to buy it from me. You know? So what does that tell you right there? Like Elder Apostle
Talbot. It's all about the money.
You guys got to wake the, like my man said, you got to wake the fuck up, you know. It says, verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up some other way, the same as a thief and a robber. Yep. But he that entereth in by the door is Yahweh Shai, all right? By the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth. And the sheep hear his voice, and he calleth his own sheep by name, and leadeth them out.
Yeah, because you guys are none of his.
Yeah, because you guys are none of his. That's why you can't call on that name. You know, and if you call on a name, you eventually what you do is you revert back to saying Christ or Jesus. You know? Because you're none of his. You know, you're caught up under that spell, that darkness. You know, that angel got that blocker on you. You know, but you're trying to say the name, but you might say it, but then mostly what you say is Jesus or Christ.
That's right. It says, and when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice, which is the truth. And a stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. And that voice, Nate's, is...
Well, Nate, them windows shoppers, they thinking about fleeing, but they scared.
Come.
Motherfucker, be a man, man.
Yeah.
And let me say this, man. This stuff about Nate having a meeting with the woman because their husbands ain't right, I'll be damned if my woman gonna go up to another man and bring my ass to counsel. They didn't do that shit back at One West. Because I would have got Connell on a nigga quick. You don't tell me what, you don't bring my woman to counsel to find out what's going on, man.
God.
What kind of man are you, man? I'm her lord. I'm her God, man.
That's right.
Don't have another man counsel your wife. Have your woman bring you to counsel. What you window shoppers should do is just get the fuck out of there, man.
Yeah, that's
for
right.
For the Most High, bring destruction on that place. Because the Lord is not dealing with Nate. He ain't dealing with Uncle Ben either. Okay?
That's right.
You know what I mean by Uncle Ben. Y'all, what's up? That old nigga. That old that's nigga, man.
That's Mr. Clean, man.
That's Mr. Negro. Grandpa nigga.
Oh, there's more, if I may. Okay. Is Yahweh Shai, you know, we laying it on the line, man. It says, this parable spake Yahweh Shai unto them, but they understood not what things they were which he spake unto them, even to this day. Niggas, they still don't get it, man. Then said Yahweh Shai unto them again, verily, verily, and he gonna make it plain, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All right? That's what Yahweh Shai said. I am the door of the sheep. So if you come in any other way but through Yahweh Shai, then you, like he said, you come in as a thief and a robber. It says, all that ever came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. He says it again. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. I mean, that's plain, man. Ain't no pasture. There's no pasture with Nate, man. Ain't nothing but that. Ain't nothing but a desert, man. Yeah, a few scabs of weeds, you know.
Chemtrails.
Yeah.
That's polluted water, man. Chemtrails, swampy, murky water.
There you go.
That's all you're gonna get with Nate. Matter of fact, I got another precept. This is the book of Romans 8:9. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the spirit of the Most High dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the spirit of Yahweh Shai, he is none of his. And you guys are none of his. That's why you can't call on that name. You know, like I said, dude, the majority of you guys, even the ones that have the name of the Lord, your conversation is mostly Christ and Jesus and all that. You know, you got to, them name has to be pushed. We're getting closer and closer to the end. Salvation is coming soon. So you got that name has to be exalted as much as possible.
The definition of Nate is a bullshit artist. Now I looked up the word bullshit artist and it sent me to Urban Dictionary. Dictionary. Now listen at this. That's what Yeshua would say. Listen at this. It says, someone with a talent for convincing lies.
Oh, that's him. That's that
someone
nigga.
Who lies, boasts incessantly.
Oh, that's
usually
that
to comedic effect, intentional or accidental. Wordsmith, right? And I said there's a quote, right, by El Toro Grande, right?
The big bull. The big bull.
Hey, it says, he said, this is what El Toro Grande says, a.k.a. Nate, I swear tomorrow.
El Toro Grande.
This is what El Toro Grande said.
New fries at Taco Bell. Yeah, the new sandwich at
got
Taco Bell.
Yeah, got a purple and gold wrapping on it. I swear tomorrow.
Purple and gold. Guys, that drunk.
you read it. I can read it, brother.
It says, I swear tomorrow I will wear a matador costume. That's what Nate got. Nate got the matador.
They were like the Passover. That was a matador costume.
Oh, yeah. That motherfucker came. If a bull came, he would have woo.
All that bull.
El Toro.
Hey, Nate must be Taurus. He must be signed under Taurus. All that bull.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. Oh, I got the scripture. This is the book of 2 Corinthians 11 and 4. It says, for if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus, and that's what Nate is preaching.
Yeah, when you say Christ, that's another Jesus.
That's another Jesus.
Because the world kept secret is the true name. Well, who are the true people of the Most High?
Yeah.
All right, who are they?
Yeah.
And it's getting out like wildfire, man. Everybody knows, thanks to YouTube, man.
Come.
You know, thanks to 8 years, 9 years of YouTube, this thing is all over the place, man. Esau don't. That's why Jay Rockefeller said what he said, man. Yeah.
That's why he said it.
The internet should have never been invented, man. And if he was dead, he'd be rolling around his grave right now, man. That's why you want to do away with the internet.
That's right.
Okay? This thing is out, man. People know who you crackers. You know that you're Edomites. All right? And most of you Jakes, you know that you're Israelites. And them black Babylonians, they can't do a sit down without mentioning the Bible or Hebrew Israelites.
Gun.
Okay?
Yeah, well, before we got on YouTube, you was on YouTube, Nate, and nothing happened. All right? Through the spirit of Yahweh Shimei Shai, we set the bar concerning this thing of ours, man, concerning the truth. That can't be denied. All of a sudden, you're this big spiritual guru. You fucking
El Toro
phony.
Grande.
El Toro Grande. You fucking phony. 2 Corinthians 11 and 4. It says, for if he that cometh preacheth another Jesus. That's what Nate is doing. With that bullshit. That El Toro Grande shit that he's teaching. For if he cometh preaching another Jesus, whom ye have not preached, or if ye receive another spirit. That's what he has. He has another spirit, a wicked spirit, which ye have not received, or another gospel. That's what he has, another gospel, which ye have not accepted, ye might well bear with him. So for now, we have to bear this nigga till Yahweh Shimei Shai take that clown out of the way.
Yeah, because like you said, he's all about money, right? This is Ezekiel 22 and 27. Her princes... And he's one of the princes of Babylon the Great. Her princes, in the midst thereof, are like wolves ravening the prey, to shed blood and to destroy souls, to get dishonest gain. And that's what you're doing. You're doing all these things to get dishonest gain.
This is the book of Micah. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's the book of Micah, chapter 3, verse 5. Thus saith the Lord concerning the prophets that make my people err, that bite with their teeth and cry peace, and he that putteth not into their mouths, they even prepare war against him. Therefore shall night be unto you that you shall not have a vision, and it shall be dark unto you that you shall not divine.
Well, wait a minute. His wife had a vision. She had a vision of factories making garments in different colors. Like this year it'll be purple and gold. Next year it'll be orange and black or whatever the hell she said. But that was her vision. They don't have the vision, which is the correct vision of seeing America being destroyed. They don't have that vision.
Gone. And you know what's funny? You know, like last week, you know, We were talking about Nate's cape. He had a white and gold cape. You know, he was dressed in white and gold. And the apostles mentioned that skit with Richard Pryor.
Yeah.
And Richard Pryor came out that he had a white and gold cape on with a white and gold garment. You know, and he, but the only difference is his had fur on it, and Nate didn't.
And that song was playing in the background, Money, Money, Money. That's what Nate is all about, man. And if you morons can't see that, then you deserve what you're about to get. That nigga is all about money, man. Yep. Him and his vampirous wife. All right? This is the book of 2 Corinthians 11 and 13. It says, for such are false apostles, deceitful workers, transforming themselves into the apostles of Yahushua. And no marvel, for Satan himself is transformed into an angel of light. That's what a lot of you look at Nate as, being an angel of light, when he's really the angel of darkness, right? He's the prince of darkness. Therefore, it is no great thing if his ministers also be transformed as the ministers of righteousness. Like when they sit on that panel, they act like they're the ministers of righteousness. And they don't even, one of them don't even know how to break down a scripture, an easy scripture correctly, which is the book of Galatians, I think it's 3 and 18.
3 and 28.
But they appear as being ministers of righteousness, whose end shall be according to their works. And that's why Apostle Eleazar said, when that spirit of death is coming, man. You know? That's it.
I got one, Micah 3 and 1. And I said, here, I pray you, O heads of Jacob, because you claim to be one of the heads of Jacob, right? And ye princes of the house of Israel, is it not for you to know judgment? 2, who hate the good and love the evil, who pluck off their skin from off them. And that goes hand in hand with Ezekiel 37. Yeah. Yeah. And their flesh from off their bones. Who also eat the flesh of my people and flay their skin from off them. Yeah. And they break their bones and chop them in pieces as for the pot and as flesh within the cauldron. All right, 4. Then shall they cry unto the Lord. Those are those window shoppers. A lot of motherfuckers are going to cry unto the Lord. They're going to stop window shopping and they're going to cry to the Lord, Yahweh. Then shall they cry unto Yahweh by Hashem Yahushai, but he will not hear them. So you have a point where you're going to try to get yourself straight, but it's going to be too late for a lot of y'all, man. The time is now. He will even hide his face from them at that time, as they have behaved themselves ill in their doings. For you to keep following Nate, guys like Nate, and I would say Comfy, but nobody really follows Comfy. Basically, he got a bunch of women.
Possible in the scab. If I pull a scab off and it still bleeds, is that an issue?
And it was a sacrifice. He got nothing but women. That's a coffin, man. That's a big gigantic coffin, man. You see Shaw back there looking dead. You see Ariel looking dead. You see the congregation looking dead. That's the congregation of the dead, man. So we don't even talk about Comfy. He's so insignificant. We don't even talk about that guy. We talk about Nate because he's a big guy now. He's a new daddy rich. El Toro Grande. All right? But anyway, I'm gonna go back into that, and I'm going to bring up a video that I believe he put up maybe a year and a half, 2 years ago, dealing with the mark of the beast. And I'm going to let it go, then I'm going to stop, then I'm going to play it, and I'm going to stop. All right? So let's get this thing set up as soon as I can find my remote. Bear me for 1 minute. You can say a few words.
Okay, I got a scripture here. Malachi 2 and 7 and 8. For the priest's lips should keep knowledge, and they should seek the law at his mouth, for he is the messenger of the Lord of hosts. But ye are departed out of the way. Again, a good example, the best example right now is Nate. Ye have caused many to stumble at the law. He's always talking about the law, but really he causes many to stumble at the law. What's an example of that? The name of the Heavenly Father, which is a law, that you honor the name of the Heavenly Father and His Son. That's a law. All right? It says, the scripture says, to extol His name, which means to put it on high. All right? But ye are departed out of the way. Ye have caused many to stumble at the law. I just gave you an example concerning Nate. Ye have corrupted the covenant of Levi, saith the Lord of hosts. That's it.
Okay. So I'm going to start this.
Both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
And he causeth all. He causeth all. He causeth all. In this chapter, what is it making reference to? Yes.
Verse 8. And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship.
Very good. And all that dwell upon the earth. And the bottom of verse 7. Read the bottom of verse 7.
And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations.
Now, he just had the zombie next to him read Revelation 13, what was that, 16, right? And now you can leave it on there. You can leave it on there because I want to look at the screen. Then I'll tell you to come back. Okay, so this is Revelation 13 and 7, right? It says, and it was given unto him to make war with the saints of Israel, and to overcome them. And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations. Now watch, he's going to... The zombie next to him is going to read that, and then he's going to come back, and he's going to say it's talking about nations, right? Now, when you go a verse down from Revelation 13, 16, and 17, it says men, right? Now, I mentioned saints. Now, when you go to, in a little bit, we're going to go into Revelation 20 and 4, and it's going to tell you that the apostles rejected the mark of the beast. The mark, all right? So now Nate is going to continually push this thing out that this mark of the beast is referring to nations. And one video he says embargo. The next video he says in Christianity, now I think he's saying it's fornication. One video he said it was sin. He always changes it, right? And the reason why he makes these videos is because of us. Because he's set up to do damage control. Now what I did was, I went to, I was going to different YouTube videos, and I ran into the video with the GOCC, and the head elder of was Ricard, which we call Bubbleize. He was dealing with a so-called Jew, and he said, are you going to take that mark of the beast, which is a chip, you know, the monetary system? He broke it down right. Now, I know for a fact that the HODC, they also teach that the mark of the beast is the chip. So I went to their website, to their YouTube page, and I went into search, and I put in mark of the beast, nothing comes up. So they know that the mark of the beast is the chip, but they're afraid to bring it out for some reason. So they really don't believe it, man. You know? They're really lukewarm. You know, the HODC, that's really the weakest Israelite group out there, bar none. They're weak. Them guys are weak. You don't see them for like 6 months, and all of a sudden they pop up. They're on fire. Then they'll join forces with Baloo. And then Baloo teaches a totally different doctrine than what they teach. They teach that the mark of the beast is a chip. Baloo says different. He says it's a potato chip, all right, which Nate even said, the only chip I'm going to take is a potato chip. And that's where this idiot Baloo got that from. And Baloo's always praising Nate. He praises Nate, but he will not get down with Nate. Okay? I thought he's looking for a leader. He's always praising Nate, man.
That's right.
All
right,
but anyway, it says, I'm going to read it again. It says, and it was given unto him to make war with the saints, those are the Israelites, and to overcome them. All right? And power was given him which is the beast, over all kindreds and tongues and nations. Now the word kindred, look up the word kindred in that scripture right there. Look at the word kindred. And then you people that say that all you guys really go into is the mark of the beast and all that. You know what? If you don't like it, you can watch another video. You don't have to watch. We ain't begging you guys to watch us. Even though our scoffers are the number, they're the first ones on our videos, man. They can't wait till Sunday afternoon to see what the new video is going to be. So in reality, they're our biggest fans, man. Okay? The ones of you that say that we teach the same thing over and over about the mark of the beast, guess what? You don't got to watch us. We're not forcing you to watch us. You don't got to. You don't have. This is only for an elect group of people. Now, the reason why we keep pushing prophecy and name mainly the mark of the beast, because I said the two big major prophecies is the war with Iran and the mark of the beast. But really, the mark of the beast is the main one. That's the main one. The war with Iran and Russia, that's the end game. That's the end game. When that happens, put your seatbelts on and get ready to get beamed up or get ready to be destroyed by fire. The major prophecy is the mark of the beast. That's why I did a thing called the hour of temptation. That's the hour of temptation. Because the ones of you guys, when they did this thing with the other day with the Supreme Court, they ruled on the Obamacare. Now remember, you have a majority Senate and Congress, meaning you got the House of Representatives and the Senate, that's both majority Republican. So they figure when they got up in there, they can switch everything over. What happened? It went to the Supreme Court. And what did they rule? That the Obamacare, they call it the Obamacare, is constitutional. So all that majority Senate, majority House of Representatives is Republican is all bullshit, man. And I think the deciding vote was Justice Roberts, which, by the way, in the first montage that I brought up, when this guy was being confirmed, he went before the Senate to sit down as a Chief Justice. It was this guy. What's this guy? The Vice President, the current Vice President Biden. He was the one that said. And the producer bring it back up. He basically said, you're going to rule on whether some people should have chips in their head. So just like the bottom line was, the last word was the Supreme Court, right? Well, that's going to be the new thing. When there's going to be major turmoil dealing with something in the law, they're going to take it to the Supreme Court. They're going to do what I said as a certiorari to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court's going to rule on it. Now, Roberts, Justice Roberts, his seat was for the Chief Justice. And like I said, Biden said, you are going to rule on whether a person should take a chip in their forehead or in their brain. All right? So that was back in 2005, because that's when Biden was a senator. He wasn't a vice president yet. And that was before Barack Obama. So they already had it set up that this guy was going to, in the future, he said, before your tenure, he said, you're going to rule on whether somebody should get a chip in their forehead, man. Matter of fact, you know what? I'm going to get it. I'm going to bring it back up again. Say something.
You got that definition? Apostle
Yeah, well, that was a patriarch.
Kindred.
I'm sorry, kindred. Yeah, kindred. Yeah, the Greek word is phula. It says tribe.
Both small and great.
In the New Testament, all the persons descending from one of the 12 sons of the patriarch Jacob, a nation, people. You know what's interesting? It says the word nation is in that scripture in Revelation. I looked up that word nation in the etymology of the word nation. I get right to the point. It says birth, origin, breed, stock, kind, species, race of people. So when he said small nations and great nations of what? Nations of people. So even by him trying to use the word nation, that shows his ignorance to the meaning of the word nation. But it also shows you that the nation is talking about his people. Because if you look up the etymology of the word, it clearly says it right here. Species, meaning species of people, race of people, tribe. All right, so again, the use of the word nation there in Revelation is talking about people. So when it says small nations and great nations, it means small people, great people. People make up nations, man. Nations make up people.
And what I notice about Nate's videos on the comment board, those are shallow people. They'll say, great video, you know? Or they'll say, you know, thank you, Elder Bishop Nate, for clearing this thing up. So basically, you're sitting there to see what Nate says. You're not going by the fact. You're just seeing what's the bottom line when it comes to Nate. And whatever Nate says, if he says whales speak French at the bottom of the sea, you niggas will believe that, man, because you're zombies, all right? If he said there is such a thing as Santa Claus and he went to a couple of scriptures, you actually believe that Santa Claus exists. He can go to certain scriptures and make you believe that Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer exists and Easter bunnies lay eggs. All he got to do is go to Acts 12 and 4, if I'm not mistaken, when it says Easter. And he can make you zombies worship Easter, man.
Well, they should. They don't believe in the Greek, so they should worship Easter. It says it right there.
Well, one of the holidays of Christ is Easter.
Easter,
and they call on Christ. But anyway, here's the video, right? It's in the Bible. It's not mentioned in the Quran. It's not mentioned in the Kibra Negas, the Metaneta, the Epic of Gilgamesh. It's not mentioned. The only book that is mentioned is in the scriptures.
Can a microscopic tag be implanted in a person's body to track his every movement? There's actual discussion about that. You will rule on that, mark my words, before your tenure is over. Can brain scans be used to determine whether a person is inclined toward criminality or violent behavior?
Did y'all hear that, man? So that mark of the beast thing, that microchip thing, and now Nate finally admits to it that yes, there is a mark. There's a microchip thing, but he's saying that's not talking about the mark. Mark of the Beast. He made a recent video, right? And I think the YouTube page is IUIC in the Classroom 2. And basically, that first video on that particular page was on the Mark of the Beast. But why? Because he has to do more damage control. Because there's so many news articles about this RFID technology. In this video that I'm going to show you that he did like a year and a half ago, maybe 2 years ago, he said that the RFID, and he had the congregation of zombies laugh. He said, what is an RFID chip? It's a tracking device. You don't buy stuff and you don't pay for stuff with it. Well, you're going to see that you can access the RFID you use. It is a tracking device, but you can also pay for things and buy things. All right?
Yeah, I think it was Shakespeare said, oh, what a tangled web we weave when at first we practice to deceive.
Because you gotta do damage control. All right? So now, go ahead.
This is the book of Ezekiel 13. And 6, because our Elder Tar was saying something about Nate zombies, a question or something like that. Well, this is what he'll say, whatever he say, and they'll just accept it. because this is what the scriptures say, Ezekiel 13 and 6. They have seen vanity and lying divination, that's Nate, saying, the Lord saith, and the Lord hath not sent them, and they have made others to hope that they would confirm the word. You know, so basically trying to make whatever Nate says, they'll accept it. You know, because he's confirming the word to them. That's why he has the greatest sin upon him. You know, because they're going to be destroyed because they're being simple, and he's going to be destroyed because he's leading them astray on purpose. He knows what he's doing. Oil Can Harry knows what he's doing. Did you have something else?
Yeah, I wanted to comment on what Biden said. He said there's actual discussion on that. You will rule on that. Meaning they have been, Biden is saying that they have been discussing.
Did you say what Ye said that? I believe it was 2005?
No,
I can find out.
Yeah. But Biden made the statement. He said there's been actual discussion on that. You will rule on that. Meaning that's what the senators have been talking about, which is putting chips in people. Now, this is Psalm 64 and 5. It says, they encourage themselves in an evil matter. That's them. That evil matter is to put a chip inside of people. They commune of laying snares privately. Did not Biden say that you will rule on that, that there's been a discussion on that? Meaning what? The discussion of putting chips in people. They say, who shall see them? So this is an example, man. That microchip, it's been discussed. It's on the table. The senators, they're all with it. You know the international bankers are with it. The Rothschilds, the Rockefellers. They dream of having a chip in every person for maximum control. So who the hell is this clown Nate?
He's one of your flunkies.
Yeah. Man, I can't wait till the Most High move you out of the way, man. You're a blot. You're a spot. A black spot on a nice, pretty white wall, man. That's you, you know?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. You know, because, you know, basically you're leading the people astray on purpose. This is Jeremiah 23 and 1.
If I may say quick, he's the fly in the ointment. You know, you have like a nice tube of ointment, and a fly comes from wherever the hell it comes from, probably from a shit house, and then it lays on the ointment, and it desecrates the ointment. That's him, man, a fly in the ointment.
Con, that's right, that's right. This is Jeremiah 23 and 1. It says, woe be unto the pastors that destroy and scatter the sheep of my pasture, saith the Lord. Because at one time, Nate knew the proper way to break the scriptures down, you know. And he still knows the name of the Lord, you know, but he's leading these people astray on purpose. I mean, he's teaching them that they're Israelites, which that's good, but you got to give them the whole thing. You can't just give them a half a plate of food. They got to get all that nutrition up in them. No, they need all their minerals and vitamins and all that.
To add to what you said, even the Apostle Paul said, I have not shunned to declare unto you the whole counsel of the Heavenly Father. Can't give it to them piecemeal, man. You got to give them the vegetables, the meat, the herbs.
The Most High, Yahweh Bashemir Shai, told Ezekiel, eat the whole roll. And then go out and teach the children of Israel. Okay, so they're not doing that, man. They're guilty of, you know, not teaching the whole roll or eating the whole roll, or whether they ate the whole roll, they're not going out and teaching the children of Israel with the whole roll. Now, this right here, this is from the news, right? Current events. This is dated May 8, 2013, and this is from CNN. And I'm going to send y'all all the links so you can put them up. It says, brain implants restoring memory with a microchip. Okay? See, that's why he has to do all this damage control.
Yeah, because of that web that he weave. If he were the first told the truth, he wouldn't have to do no damage control. That's the thing about the truth. It's a done transaction. Once you give the truth, that's it. You don't have to, when you lie, you have to think about the lie that you told. Now you have to tell another lie to cover that lie. And before you know it, you're in a web full of lies, man. Just tell the truth.
Well, he was getting paid off to do otherwise. This is another story. And it says here, implant memory chips in our brains
by Caroline Rothstein, a so-called Jew. I'm not going to go, like I said, you'll see the, and this, and I think the name of the site is bigthink.com. Let me see what year was this put out. I can't find the year, but, but here's another one. Okay, this is another story, and I'll give you the link. I'm not going to read it. There's a lot of reading here. It says, ethical assessment of implantable brain chips. Ellen M. McGee and G.Q. McGuire Jr. And like I said, you'll see the link. So, I mean, it's out there, man. You know, this is prophecy coming to pass. Ooh, and this is a good one. This is from before it's news, and I think we went to the site before. This is what you would call alternative news source. This was dated Friday, August 1st, 2014. And it says, Russia exposes U.S. secretly forced brain chip mind control weapon. Because these other nations, their intelligence, that's why they're in power. And they know what's going on, man. Yeah. They have guys read the Bible and break down the Bible and all that, man. So that's another one. Yeah. Okay, I'm gonna read a little bit of it. Okay, it says, secretly forced human brain implants connected to a computer for mind control is a reality today, one that has shattered lives of hundreds of thousands of innocent victims globally. It is today's most hidden human rights abuse, and Russia has taken the lead to expose it in a TV news program that the host called a profound interview with a leading targeted individual advocate from Sweden. All right, I'm not going to read any more on that story, all right? You can read it when you get a chance. So, that's the most major prophecy.
Oh, yeah.
The war with Iran and the war with Russia, that's an end game, which is the fulfillment of prophecy. Okay, when that happens, you know everything's going to move quick, super quick. But when they actually go back and forth, because you're going to have these Bible Belt people that's not going to accept that chip because they're going to say it's a mark of the beast. You're going to have protesters out there. You're going to have different Christians. You're going to have other people waking up. You're going to have so-called non-Christians that's not going to take it because they just don't want to take it. And then you're going to have people that's going to want to take it that have no problem taking it. And yeah, then they're going to make it popular. And then that's when reality is going to hit you zombies in the face. Because ultimately, we won. The men of the Most High won. Because you say that the mark of the microchip is not the mark of the beast. But then you say in the last video, we're not going to take a chip anyway. Well, then we won.
That's right.
We won.
Yeah.
You doing what we say do, which the Most High told us to tell you what to do, man.
That's right.
So at the end of the day, we won, man.
That's right.
And we say, don't go this way, go that way. And you say, that's a lie, I'm going the other way. But you go the way we say go, then we won. Because you're thinking about it right now. Especially you window shoppers, man.
Yeah.
You guys that are not deep into that zombie curse that Nate, that spell that Nate has you in, man.
Yeah, breaking.
Some of you are breaking that spell. Some of you window shoppers, like I said, go ahead and break that window and don't even buy it. Go ahead and grab it, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, come.
You see that? You window shopping?
bust a window, man, and grab it. Okay? The window's here to be busted, man.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah, Nate is becoming transparent like a window.
That's right.
I see right
That's
through
right.
that clown.
Go ahead.
This is, I went online. This is, I guess, Intel. It's called, it's from the a site called Unwitting Victims, Intel. It says, Intel brain implant chip available for the consumer market by 2020. Statements quoted and sourced. Intel released that it will have brain chips for the consumer market by 2020. The brain implants, Intel states, will enable consumers to type without a keyboard or mouse, control the TV without a remote, make calls and surf the web simply by using their brain waves. The consumer will be able to control computers as well as other things in the environment with nothing more than thought. Intel thinks people will warm to the idea. Andrew Chien, Vice President of Research and Director of Future Technologies Research at Intel Labs, stated, if you told people 20 years ago that they would be carrying computers all the time, they would have said, I don't want that. I don't need that. Now you can't get them to stop carrying devices. He went on to state that there are a lot things that have to be done first, but I think implanting chips into human brains is well within the scope of possibility. You know, because they plan on doing it. They have the technology already.
And a lot of people, they're going to see that as a miracle.
Yeah.
Now, that reminds me of this scripture. It says, Revelation 16 and 14, for they are the spirit of devils working miracles. So a lot of people are going to, just what you read, they're going to look at the chip as being a miracle. Oh, that's a miracle. Now, you know what's heavy? If you look up that word miracle in the blue letter Bible, the word there is, let me play the Greek.
Strong's G, 4592, Semaion.
And it says a sign, mark, a token. They're the spirit of devils working miracles, the mark of the beast. What is that? The chip. The chip will appear as a miracle to the majority of these people.
Yeah.
As a miracle of technology, this chip.
Yeah, because if I may say this, because even as we speak now, you have a certain people that are paraplegics and they can use, you know, a brain implant into their head and use a computer and stuff. So it's not without beyond the realm of impossibility that they can use that same implant to move their limbs, you know, possibly even walk again.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, the chip is going to appear as a miracle. And just like the prophecy says, for they are the spirits of devils, because that's coming from the devil, working miracles. That's an example, that chip. Which go forth unto the kings of the earth and of the whole world to gather them to the battle of the great day of the power almighty. And just like Apostle Tahar mentioned about the third world's war, that's the two big prophecies, the chip and the third world's war. Well, you're getting that combined in
the
that
major
verse.
Prophecy is the mark of the beast.
Yeah.
The hour of temptation. That's the major prophecy, man.
Yeah.
And it's going to shake a lot of people up, man. It's going to shake a lot of people up. Especially when they eventually take it up to the Supreme Court and they say it's law and you got to take that chip. That's when you're going to see revolutions, man.
Potentially stand up.
That's when you're going to see people losing it, man. Anyway, let's go back to this.
It's very hard.
This guy, this Baron Samedi chap.
Allowing people much better control that they would be able to carry out a range of normal functions, but maybe not even.
Let me go back. Bear with me for a minute.
Again, we don't know.
Donahue went on to say that many tens of millions of dollars have been spent so far by his team to develop BrainGate, but the technology is still in its infancy. Once on the market, he expects BrainGate to cost tens of thousands of dollars for
both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
And he causeth all. He causeth all. He causeth all. In this chapter, what is it making reference to? Yes.
Rabbi.
Huh?
Verse 8. And all that dwell upon the earth shall worship.
Very good. And all that dwell upon the earth. And the bottom of verse 7.
You can see that devil working his magic on over those zombies. You got to keep them zombies in check. Now, if you notice, the video is not in sync with the voiceover, right? It's off. So you might be saying, well, that's not Nate really talking. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let it go, and I'm going to give you the actual video so you can actually see the actual video, all right? I'm going to put it back on.
Read the bottom of verse 7.
And power was given him over all kindreds and tongues and nations.
Right. Now, read verse 16 again.
And he causeth all, both small and great.
Stop. Read it slow.
And he causeth all, both small and great.
Read it slow. You're rushing.
And he causeth all, both small.
Both small nations. Go ahead.
Don't even say
and
that.
Great.
It don't even say nation there. Yeah, just, you know, it's, he said both small nations. He's just adding to the word. You know? This guy is a real demon, and he's working, like Apostle Tar just said, he's working his magic right before you, and you don't even see this big matador costume wearing, his matador costume wearing ass fool doing this thing, man. He's working that magic right before you.
And even if he inserts the word nations, nations of what? Nations of zebras? Nations of robots? Nah, nations of people, man. The very word nation, the etymology, I just read it for you, brothers, means people, race, breed of people. So you fail once again, Nate. Hey, this is the book of Proverbs 30 and 5, beginning at 5. It says, every word of the Most High is pure. He is a shield unto them that put their trust in him. Add thou not unto his words, lest he reprove thee, which the Lord is doing that right now. Yehovah Shimei Yahusha is doing that right now through us. That's a lot of you say, why are you always getting on Nate? Because we're set up to reprove him. That's why. The scriptures say.
Because he's a devil. That's why.
Yeah, there you go. He's a big black devil. All right. The scriptures say to rebuke.
Hold on. When Michael went to get the body of Moses, Satan rolled up. What did he do? He didn't put up a railing accusation. He rebuked him in the name of Yehovah Shimei Yahusha.
Come.
So that's what we're doing. We're rebuking all devils, man.
All devils. Okay? Not just Nate. He just happens to be the most popular devil.
Yeah, hey, brother, that's going to be like an ongoing series. Yeah. Rebuking all devils.
Rebuking all devils. Hey, we got weeds in the garden, man. You don't just look at the weed. You got to.
And like I said, any of you guys that are offended by this, and that you say we're saying the same thing over and over again,
right.
Why are we getting on Nate? All you got to do is one thing. Don't watch our videos.
Just don't watch.
Don't watch. Protest our videos, man. Don't watch our videos. You're the first guys to watch our videos when they come up. Unbelievable, man.
Hey, well, we're saying the same thing over and over again. I guess they never read the law. The law is very repetitious. So much so that Monty Python made a skit on that. They made a skit about how repetitious the law is. So I guess you don't know the nature of the Heavenly Father.
And St. Athelot took out the holy hand grenade, and he didn't put it in his hand, and he pulleth the holy pin.
Yep.
Count thou to three. Neither count thou one, neither two, but the number to reach is three. That's a skit from Monty Python. Okay?
Yeah.
Which are comedians and scholars.
And scholars, yeah.
And scholars from That's England.
Right. That's right.
Yeah. You know how I know that they were scholars? Because they did a movie called, Quest for the Holy Grail? Monty Python and the Holy Grail or whatever?
Yeah, yeah.
And the Most High came, and it looked just like the Most High in the scriptures.
So-called
It was
black
a black man,
yep.
And he was cursing them guys out.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's how I know that them guys were scholars, man.
That's right.
And comedians, man. But that's anyway, this video that I said, I mentioned that... The video is not in sync. You know, the sound, but the video is not in sync. So you don't think that we're, you know, messing up and putting a voiceover of Nate from a different video or it's another guy. You can go to YouTube and put in all cap, the mark of the beast, IUIC, and the name of the site, the YouTube page is Medan Ben Israel. And it says 1 year ago, and it had 5,269 views. So, I mean, you can watch it, all right? So you don't think we're bullshitting you, okay? Because we're not bullshit artists. We give it to you straight, no chaser.
Yeah, Proverbs 30:6.
And great nations. A small nation is called what today?
Third world
country. What's a great nation called?
Now, go to the 17th verse of that same chapter. Because he does actually go to it, and I don't think he realized he went to it. He had to cover his ass.
Okay.
He said that the 16th verse, Revelation 13 and 16, is talking about nations, right? The people, the one that's going to receive the mark is nations. It's referring to nations, right?
Yeah.
17th verse.
And
when I ran into two of his zombies, which them brothers were cool, you know? Them guys were cool. I had a good time with them, man. Because we first looked at each other and shit. Then we, you know, hey, we cool with each other, man. Because we spoke for about a good 25 minutes. And then you know what I did? I went right into I wasn't going to say, how you doing? How's it day? I went right into the scriptures, man. I said, let's go on to the scriptures. And then even when we were talking, there were people passing by and they wanted to stop and listen. A couple of people stopped and listened, man. That's how intense the conversation was, man. The back and forth. So when I went into the thing about the mark of the beast and the chip and so forth, the brother read it and he mimicked Nate word for word, same hand gesture and every damn thing, man. And then I told him to go to 17 verse, and maybe he didn't realize it, but he kind of went into something else. But it was basically they didn't want to deal with that 17 verse. Okay. They didn't want to deal with that 17th verse. Just like Nate really doesn't want to deal with it now. But like I said, he goes into it, but he kind of, you know, does the whole soft shoe on it, right? So read the 17th verse, which cut his breakdown of the 16th verse.
Right. And that no man might buy or sell.
There you go.
Yeah.
No man might buy or sell, right? Now the word, now you can't say, well, the word man really means nation, because that's another way of saying it. Because he's going to bring out a scripture in Colossians 2 and 8, and the same word man is in there. The Greek word is tis,
right,
which means an actual man, a person, someone. All right? So we're going to go back.
The free world. Right, a superpower. The European countries. Go ahead.
Rich and poor.
Rich nations are called what? You just said it. Same thing. He's saying the same thing. Jonathan, let me use different words.
Jacobus.
Right.
You got to say it clearer and clearer.
Read it again.
And he calls it all, both small.
Small nations.
And great.
And great nations.
Rich.
Rich nations.
You notice it didn't say nations. He added that in there, man.
That's right.
Proverbs, or what was that, Proverbs 30:6. Go to that, somebody. Proverbs 30:6.
Yeah. Proverbs 30:6, it says, add thou not unto his words, lest he reprove thee, and thou be found a liar.
Okay, so you people getting on us about getting on Nate. We're not getting on Nate. The Most High, Yahweh Hashem, is getting on Nate through us.
That's it.
So you getting carnal, man. You leave Nate alone. Why are you getting on Nate? Well, my answer is we're not getting on Nate. The Most High is getting on Nate. He's right. Speaking through us.
Yeah.
Okay?
Well, if his purpose was to deceive, then that was the wrong choice of word. Like I said, nations of what? Nations of Daleks, you know, from Doctor Who? No, nations of people, man. So he used the wrong word. He should have used a different word. Nations, rich nations, poor nations. Yeah, nations of people.
In other words, when you know, teaching lies, get your lies straight, man.
Exactly. And poor nations. Free.
Free? What's a free nation? Name me a free nation.
America.
America's a free world. Europe is a free world. Go ahead.
And bond.
And bond. Those are what? Third world. Third world countries. Go ahead.
To receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
Now that's the verse we wanted to get through this whole day.
Where's the right hand and the forehead of a nation? Huh, Nate? Where's the right hand and or the forehead of a nation? That's another topic. Go ahead. All right, we got, we're moving on.
RFID chip. RFID chip. What does it stand for? Radio frequency identification.
When he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark.
Hold up. Hold up. Wait a minute. Look at he got the what do you call it? The Aleister Crowley symbol up, you know, do as thou wilt, you know, the pyramid with the open capstone with the eye floating on top of his head. Look at that. And my man over here, he don't know what the hell is going on.
He never knows what's going on. He always has that little boy lost look.
Stop. So the subject is, with this particular mark, you can't buy or sell. Can somebody tell me what a radio frequency chip has to do with that? A radio frequency identification is meant as what? A GPS. To find location. Where's my dog? A sister wrote me and said, my dog has an RFID chip. I said, well, maybe he can go buy some land for you. Simple as hell. A radio frequency identification chip is like a G. You can find the location of whoever got it. Yeah.
Like in your metro car, in your phone, your car.
Here comes Mr. Law's boy. The Law's boys. Let me go back. I gotta go back.
Identification.
When he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
And that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark.
Stop. So the subject is, with this particular mark, you can't buy or sell. Can somebody tell me what a radio frequency chip has to do with that?
Well, here's your answer. New pay as you go, pay as you go, RFID system, right? Could somebody read that? Get the mic and read. I can't see it. Get the mic. Read the second line there.
It says TransCore will make it possible for people to use RFID toll collection system to pay for parking.
Now he's suggesting that. It's just the global positioning system, GPS. But you can't buy or sell with it, right? Well, look at the document, man. Okay?
A radio frequency identification is meant as what?
And the nigga think because he yells at the top of his lungs, that makes it right. Yeah. Like if I say, I'm on 42nd Street. I want to go to 43rd Street, right? And I asked somebody, how do I go to 43rd Street? And he's pointing towards 35th Street, right? But he's yelling. I don't give a damn how much you yell. It doesn't make it right, man.
That's right.
Okay? One and one is two. I don't give a damn if you yell one and one is 37. You can yell that out at the top of your lungs. It does not make it. At any time, 37.
That's right.
Okay? So that yelling shit ain't going to get it. All
right? That's right. I got another story for you.
Go ahead.
This is from Computer World. It says, office complex implants are... the chips in employees' hands. And then it says the corporate tenants of a Swedish high-tech office.
Yeah, I did the video on that, remember? I actually did that video.
Oh, look at that.
But I'm saying that there it goes. But their thing, their comeback was that they got the chip on their left side.
Well, yeah, well, there's a scripture where it says...
Well, why don't you do it on the left side and see what happens?
Yeah, there's a scripture that
put it in your butt cheek.
Yeah.
And see what happens. Maybe the Most High, you know, you tell the Most High, look, Lord, I didn't put it in my right hand. I put it in my butt cheek.
Yeah, well, there's a scripture that mentions the hands, not just the right hand.
There's two scriptures that
there's two scriptures. Yep. Yeah.
Revelation 14 and Revelation 20.
That's right. Well,
it mentions hands.
That's right. Yeah, well, according to the story, the employees working at Epic Center, a 15,000 square foot building in Stockholm, can even pay for lunch using their implants, just as they would with the swipe of a credit card. So that again, that cuts you, Nate.
Moving on.
It's a fine location. Where's my dog? My sister wrote me and said, my dog has an RFID chip. I said, well, maybe he can go buy some land for you. Simple as hell. A radio frequency identification chip is like a G. You can find the location of whoever got that.
Yeah. Like in your metro card, in your phone, your phone.
Now, this simple nigga said a metro card. What does a metro card do? It tracks you, but you use that to pay to get on the subway, man.
Right.
Or the L.
Right.
Moving on.
Car. Whatever you lose, you'll find it.
Right. Those are chips. There's chips in it to low for locations. Now.
Galatians 13, verse 16. And he calls it all, both small and great. Rich and poor.
Talking about nations.
Free and bond. To receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead.
So this mark is... Right. This mark is a philosophy. A doctrine. Somebody might jump up and say, hey, prove that it's a philosophy. There's no scriptures. Is there a scripture that talks about that?
Yes.
Where? Yahshua.
Ezekiel 9 and 6.
Not that. Nope. Colossians 2 and 8. It's going to explain the mark.
Oh, it's going to explain the fact that...
Have you ever seen people that has had their arms amputated? How they going to get the chip?
You all, hey, Uncle Ben, sit your ass down and shut the F up.
Colossians 2 and 8.
Here it comes.
You will let any man spoil you.
Read it right so they can understand.
Colossians 2 verse 8. Beware.
Beware. Be warned.
Lest any man. Spoil you. Through philosophy.
Through what?
Philosophy.
Philosophy.
And vain deceit.
And vain deceit.
After the tradition of men.
After the tradition of men. Which men primarily was Paul addressing, making reference to? Anybody know? Was he talking about the Africans? Malachi.
The white man.
The white man.
Rome.
Because Rome was in power. So he made it simple. That's any man. What man? Because you could not come out and say, I'm talking about the white man, Rome, because what would have happened? You get killed. Rome didn't play like that. He said, any man. It could be your father. Paul was very...
What the hell is this guy talking about, man? The hell is he talking about?
Slip when he spoke. Read Colossians 2 and 8 again.
Beware, lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit. After the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ.
Watch this. Let's go back to Revelation 13. Because somebody said, there's no scripture that talks about philosophy. We just proved you a liar, brother. You could go into the Greek till your head falls off. You will not find a scripture about a chip. And the only chip I'm getting is potato chips. That's it. Ain't gonna be nothing.
Potato chips are bad for
you. He calls it chip. And he calls it Revelation 13, verse 16. And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor.
Rich nations, poor nations.
Free and bond.
Free nations, bond nations.
To receive a mark.
To receive a mark.
In their right hand.
In their right hand. Now with your right hand, because somebody might say, why does it say a mark in your right hand? A mark in your right hand. With your right hand, what do you do with terms of doctrines, with terms of philosophy? With your right hand. Yahshua?
That's when you swear oaths and things like that.
You swear oaths with your right hand. You make Isaac, come in. Me and Isaac in an agreement. Stretch out your hand. You stretch out your right hand. What happens if you go to a business meeting and put out your left hand?
They look at you funny.
They said, never trust a man that shakes an agreement with his left hand. It must always be the right hand. Mm-hmm. You support with your right hand. You pledge allegiance with your right hand. Okay? You salute with your right hand. You understand that? You give oath with your right hand. Read that again.
Yeah, you know that.
You gave an oath. 16 again.
And he calls it all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads.
Go ahead. Now, what's in your forehead? brother, I want to be loved. What's your name? Atoma. What's in your forehead? Your brain is in your forehead. So, philosophies and doctrines is up in here. With your right hand, you support them things. You pledge allegiance to them things. You make agreements to them things. Read.
And that no man.
Now what type of man is he talking about? Read 16 again.
Verse 16 again. And he calls it all, both small.
For small nations.
And great.
Great nations.
Rich.
Rich nations.
Poor.
Poor nations.
Did you hear what he said? And what type of man is that talking about? Go to 16. He says small nations and rich. That's what type of man is talking about. So, that's why we call you guys zombies, man.
Free.
Free nations.
Bond.
Bond nations. 317 again.
And that no man might buy or sell.
And that no man might buy or sell.
Save he that had the mark.
Stop. Save he that had the doctrine of philosophy. Now you might say, I need a little bit more. That, you know, people always say, I need more. But when it was that ship, they didn't need no more. But I'm going to give you some more. Give me 1 Maccabees. Here's some more precepts for you. Now I'm going to hit that. It's going to come home now. Let's see what Rome did. 1 Maccabees chapter 1. Remember, Rome came from... Rome was also called what? Go back in time. Yes.
Yeah.
Nope. Something else. Maybe I'm not wording it right. What is Rome? I'll just say. Sometimes Rome is called the Greco-Roman Empire. Because when Rome and Greece was at war, they destroyed.
Anyway, you can come back. We're gonna finish with that. Like I said, you can go to Medan Ben Israel on YouTube. And go to search and put in the Mark of the Beast, IUIC, and you can watch the whole thing. It's 15 minutes long, and from a video that was like an hour and change long. And I believe at the end of the video, they give you the site that you can watch the whole video. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna go back. Come back to that. I'm gonna go to the end of this thing, and I'm just gonna show you something.
Destroy Greece and forget about them.
Okay, that right there. Right there. Now this right here is something that Nate Satan put up. And this was, what, 08 maybe? 09? And we took a picture of it, for the record.
Yeah.
And it says the true name, and he has the Tetragrammaton. The Tetragrammaton is not the true name of the Most High. It's just a four letters put together, four consonants put together.
Okay.
And it says, divine name of the Father called, and he puts the Tetragrammaton, which is not the divine name of the Most High. Yah is not the divine name of the Most High. Although Yah is short, the abbreviated version of Yahweh, like for example, Yeshaya means Yah, which is the name of the Most High. Shaya, which means deliverer, which means Yahweh delivers. Now these guys, these GOCC guys, they're saying that's the name of his son. Well, wait a minute. The true name of the Most High is in that name. Yeshaya. Yah, which is short for Yahweh. Shaya, which means deliver. All right? Then it says, Yahweh, third pick is Yahweh. He throws the true name of the Most High in there, mingle with some bullshit. And then he adds a fourth name, which is Yahweh. Now he says, this is the divine name of the Father. So if you don't feel like using, if you're tired of saying Yahweh, you can say Yahweh. Or you can say Yah. Or you can say the Tetragrammaton. All right? Then he says, English mistranslation, Jehovah Jah. Now it says, name of the Messiah. Then he starts off with Yeshua. Then Yeshaya. Then it says, English mistranslation, Jesus. But he's always saying Christ. So he gave it a true name, mingled with some false names. And then he said in the last video that he did, what was it called? Misconceptions or something like that. Individualism or whatever. I forget the name of this. You saw it and I saw it. When you go about maybe an hour in, almost at the end, he basically says that in a roundabout way, the true name of the Son is Yahshua. And he said that at the main school, they put in the word, the I sound. I'm not saying it word for word. So don't come back, no, he didn't say that, he said that. In a roundabout way, he said it. Now, the producer can actually put that clip up, that sound bite. I'll tell you what the video is. It's like in the middle going on into the end of the video.
Get Numbers 13 and 16. Is that the right one I'm going to, Numbers 13? The name Joshua, translated in the English. So Joshua is written different ways. You can write it Joshua or Jehoshua. Or Jeshua. Watch this. Numbers 13, 16. This is about Joshua, who was under Moses.
Numbers 13, verse 16. These are the names of the men which Moses sent to spy out the land. And Moses called Hoshea, the son of Nun, Jehoshua.
Right. Hoshea, the son of Nun, with Jehoshua, that is Joshua, the son of Nun. Hoshea, it means salvation or saves, which is the same as Jehoshua. What they did now, they took out the J. It said, and originally it was the Y. Yehoshua. Mm-hmm. Now, when we came into the school, they changed the pronunciation of the last letter. The last letter on that is what? What's the letter on Jehoshua?
It's A.
Right. They changed it and said, put an I there. So they pronounce it Yehoshai. But it's the same name that one. It's the same spelling in Hebrew there that you read in, where is it? Hebrews.
So he just showed, this is from his site. going back like seven years ago. And we, and like I said, we took a picture of it, man. But he said that we change. We still call the name of Yahweh. We still call the name Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
All right?
Yeah, I got a scripture. This is the book of Leviticus 22, beginning at 31. It says, therefore shall ye keep my commandments and do them. I am the Lord.
I believe, yeah, that's it. That's it.
Neither shall ye profane my holy name. So that's one of the Lord's commandments, that you profane not his holy name. He's putting the Lord's name among that other crap. He's profaning the Lord's holy
name. But he got the true name of the Most High. He got the true, can you hear me? He got the true name of the Most High all in the middle, third in line.
Yeah, third one. Yeah.
And then the name of the Messiah, he got his second in line.
Yeah. He's profaning.
And but he said that we sold out.
Right.
Hey, we getting ready to close. You damn zombies, you better break out of that zombie spell. And you window shoppers, don't go in there and buy the product. Break the window and dive on top of the product, man. Which the product is truth. Which, yeah, we have the truth, okay?
That's it.
Like your life depends upon it. And with that, I'm going to say shalom.